Shalom, shalom. Welcome. Giving all praises to the Most High, Yahweh, Yahweh Shah. I'm Monique Gabriella, and here's Tazada.
So shalom, shalom, kome Yashallah. Once again, you're nothing to the sounds of the voice of your brother Tazada. And again,
Monique Gabriella.
So I'm just here give you an update on seminar coming up, actually in the Maryland, Washington, D.C., Baltimore, New Jerusalem, New Jersey, Philadelphia, area. If you're any of those, if you're located within any of those tri-states, there should be no reason that you shouldn't actually be at this seminar. Like, a lot of you have been actually requesting that I come to this area, so now you have it. So, I mean, some of the things is actually going to be discussed at the seminar. Like, let me pull the glasses off. Hold this for a second. So, you can see I'm not trying to hide behind my glasses or whatever. So yeah, some of the things is actually going to be discussed at the seminar is how to expunge a criminal record for educational purposes, how to clear your credit, how to deal with debt collectors and actually sue debt collectors, how to actually manage property taxes, how to actually overcome a cognitive dishonest theory, and much, much more. So it's imperative, if you want to alter your life, that you actually show up at this seminar. You know, be there. It's really no excuse. You got people flying in from places like Iowa, got people coming in from California that's actually already donated. So don't tell me if you're located in a state like New Jersey, Philadelphia, that you can't make it. That's your excuse to keep living the life that you're living right now. You keep making excuses, and therefore your life is not changing. If you want to change your life, you got to start right now in this moment. You got to change right now. You got anything you want to add?
Oh, excuse me. Shalom.
So at this seminar, yeah, I'm going to actually, I guess you got a little cough bug right there, but nevertheless, at this seminar, I'm going to actually have my books there. Like, one of the, like, hold that book up to the screen. So that's one of the books that's actually going to be available at the seminar. They're actually available online. But if you show up at my seminars, I have a tendency to give you the books for actually a discounted rate. This book is The Infliction of Commerce, the first one that I actually put out. This book has very detailed information in it. Many of you, you talk the talk, yeah, I want to be a secure party creditor, but you're not reading the literature that teaches you how to properly handle contract law. You got to come to the comprehension that contract is law and law is contract. It's all about offer acceptance, offer acceptance. When you receive an offer, what do? Do you go into acquiescence, silence, which means you do nothing, or do you argue like a debtor? Many of you cannot escape that debtor mentality. You just love polemics. You love to argue. You love the art of disputation. You're addicted to it. But now it's time to change your life, and you can start by getting this book right here. The books will be available at the seminar. Another book is that right there. This is the second edition, Commercial Warfare. We the People versus Despotism. Whether you're a secure party creditor or you're becoming a secure party creditor, this book is valuable in your library. It teaches you how I actually construct writs, affidavits of negative averment, how I handle like commercial presentments. There's so much information in this book, the accepted for value method. There's many different ways that you could actually construct an accepted for value. Do you have this book on your shelf? If you're not, you're harming yourself. Many of you just want to file the secure party creditor paperwork, but you don't want to read this literature. Therefore, you don't know how to stand as a man or a woman. And no, that's not a mispronunciation. It's not a misnomer. A woman, a man with a womb, which is the womb man, that, you know, that has the womb where your seed grows. So you got to get these books. The other book, my latest book, is Red Pill Right Knowledge. Versus the feminist, what's the name of this book? I don't forgot the name. Red Pill, Right Knowledge versus the de facto feminist allegory. Now, this book, you know, I pretty much developed for men and women that's actually having issues with child custody, child support. It shows you how I actually tackle these issues in court and won every time. So you definitely want this in your library, because if you are not affected by child custody or child support, you definitely know someone that is. So all of these things are actually a wealth of knowledge. Let me put this down. Then let me have that one. Another book that's actually dealing with nationality. Let me get those. It's this on Hebrew Israelite. So many of you change your status, but you don't claim nationality. You want to stay in a corporate ward status. Check this out. You cannot be in a proper status and you're still walking around with the name of your former slave masters. I'm not being racist. You can get in your emotions all you want to, but it's not going to change anything, and it's not going to change the truth. It's not going to change the fact that as long as you're carrying someone else's name, you cannot consider yourself to be in a proper status. You cannot have proper standing. They will look at you and laugh. So become the creditor. I'm telling you, many of you have the question like, what should I do first? Change my nationality and so on and so forth, claim my nationality, or become a secure party creditor? Become a secure party creditor first. Why do I say that? Because you want to be able to discharge debt under the corporation, under the fictitious name, under that name. So you want to actually become a creditor under that name, and then later you could, you know, alter, you know, claim your proper nationality. You know what I'm saying? For the record. But to become a secure party creditor, you want to do it under that corporate construct, that corporation name, in legis. You understand what I'm saying? So, you know, with that, you have any questions, anything you would like to add? The address for the seminar is actually on the screen. You can see it below. I actually don't have it memorized, but I'm going to add it to the screen. So, you know, be there. Make your donations now. The donations are actually going to be $45 online for singles and $180 for couples. That's male and female. No funny stuff. And so if you want to wait and try to donate at the door, however, there may be no seats because they're filling up very fast. A lot of people are actually being smart and donating online. So if you donate at the door, if there are seats left, it's going to be $55 for singles. And it's going to be $100 for couples, male and females. Anything you want to add or yell at?
Thank you for listening.
That's it? You ain't got nothing to say? No questions or nothing? You might, let me have that book. you must have some question that could actually intrigue someone that may not otherwise have come, that will cause them or provoke them or move them to attend the seminar. This is actually going to be the most informative seminar yet, because each seminar I give out more and more and more information. You have any questions that you may have actually want to ask?
Yes, actually. Well, I know a lot of people who are ex-felons. They've been out of trouble for many years now, 5+ years. And they get to that good job, and then all of a sudden that old felon or a felony comes back to bite them when they haven't been in any trouble. Is there going to be any information about how to get your record expunged, things of that nature?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, if they follow what's actually being stated, then you will actually learn how to possibly expunge a criminal record. And in states like California and so on and so forth, they're trying to make it more difficult. But if you learn, I keep emphasizing to people, you got to learn contract law. And you got to learn to look at everything as an offer. You know, stop like reading into the little meticulous things that's of like little significance. It's all about offer and acceptance. People that's on parole, many of you want to know how to deal with a parole situation. Well, a parole situation is a contract. Contracts are dynamic, and if you are a contract law expert, you can make them move, which means you can make that particular contract work in your favor. Understand that.
Thank you. Okay, my next question is, I have a brother that owns property in Africa. He owns the house, but he doesn't own the land that it's on, and he's worried about taxes or whatnot. Will you be covering anything about that subject?
First of all, excuse me for not saying this in the beginning. Giving all praises to the God of our forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, whose proper name is Yahweh, Yahuwah. So, yeah, I mean, if he's actually paying property taxes, he doesn't own it. He just thinks he own it. Because anytime that you're paying any kind of property taxes, that means there's a trust involved. That means the de facto state has legal title over that property, and if he does not pay the property taxes, that property would actually be taken away from him. So what he actually has to learn to do is to actually get a land patent or to dissolve that trust. And yes, we will be dealing with issues at the seminar on how to actually deal with these property taxes.
Thank you. Shalom. I think that concludes my questions for now.
All right, I mean, so that's going to be it. I'm going to actually bring this to a close, real short video. Hope to see you at the seminar. Be there. Get your donations in. Come with an open mind. If you're coming with a debtor mentality, you're going to be excused. We don't want any polemics at the seminar. We don't want any people that's coming to dispute or show how intelligent you are. You're not welcome here. This is all about creditors. This is actually all about creating a harmony and growing together and establishing something. So if you have that debtor mentality, you're not welcome to the seminar. I'm going to let you know straight. Do you understand? You're going to actually have to learn to humble yourself or create harmony. And to all of the naysayers, all of you with the negative energy, you're not welcome either. You need to get your mind right, King. Get your mind right, Queen. Get your minds right. And get over your fear. The last thing I want to say is that fear is the only thing that's actually a barrier between you and the person that the Most High has actually intended you to be. It's your fear that's actually hindering you, some of you, from filing your documents, some of you from making a donation for becoming a secure party creditor. Some of you are too fearful to actually go in court and place the black robe. As soon as you actually succumb that fear and overcome it, then you're going to become the man or woman that the Creator has designed you to be. So when do you do that? It starts right now. Forget about what's actually happened in the past and all of your delays and you putting things off. Because what's going to happen if you do not overcome that fear is you're going to look back 5 years from now, and you're still going to be in the same place, and you're going to be like, damn, I should have done this 5 years ago. And many of you could feel what I'm saying right now because you're guilty of it right now. So overcome your fear and be totally undaunted. Totally undaunted. You have to be undaunted. Do you understand? Do you understand? So with that, I hope to see you at the seminar. I thank you for listening. If you like the video, like the video, give the video a thumbs up, and share this video with as many people as possible. But get your donations in for the seminar now, because the seats are filling up quickly. Taza Doc and Ariella,
have a good day. Shalom.
So I'm going to say shalom, kwam yasha Allah, kwam yasha Allah, kawataza, kawataza. Peace. Two fingers.